Hello everybody, Berto Kai here, and welcome back. Alright, so we're doing an excellent match with the Conqueror. Oh, I love this tank, now that it's fully upgraded anyways. Before it was quite the grind in order to get here, it was like hell. Oh my god, it was hell. But I'm here now, I've got it fully upgraded, and I'm ready to kick some ass, and off we go to do so. So this map is a pretty decent map, I like it. Most of the action I find so far, since I've been back playing anyway, seems to be at the bottom. Most of the heavies are going anyways. Top tier in this match, which is pretty awesome. It's one of the only solo games that I play in. I don't usually play solo matches, I'm usually playing with my teammates and stuff, so it's pretty good. No complaints, good crew. Always have some good laughs when we all get together there, so yeah, it's pretty fun. No no drama, so that's always good. Don't like drama, no one does. Just a video game, right? So here we go. I think just down past this bridge, a little ways there, we start getting into our action. And we start destroying other tanks, which is going to be fun, because I did really, really good. So, walked away with like 5 kills, I think, something like that, so it's pretty wicked. Yeah, I really like this tank. I enjoy playing heavy tanks. I probably am a better heavy tank driver than maybe anything else. It's just what I enjoy doing. Being kind of like up there in the front of the battle and trading shots off with people and all that good stuff. So, yeah, I guess it's just what I like to do. So this is where the battle begins. This is for the bottom of the map. We're gonna start picking off a T-54. He don't last too long. That's for darn sure. I thought someone killed him there, but I guess not. That's fine. We'll keep going down this way, and we'll find ourselves some more victims. That's pretty much all how this match went. It was one victim after another, and it was pretty brutal. The other team got obliterated pretty bloody fast. So I could decide to come down here and see what I can find and get myself into trouble like I usually do. But this time around, I found a pretty decent way to go where I get some extra shots off. I'm actually kind of surprised I didn't pin that guy, but you know, considering that the whole side of his turret there, which is fine, it's fine. I'll just pick on this little IS in the meantime. I do get a shot off on this 103. Oh no, it's a Tiger I hit. That's right, I track him and get some damage on him, which is pretty awesome. I think later on I actually get to kill him too, which makes it even better. So there's my first kill. Just going around picking off whatever I can. It's unfortunate the reload time is not as fast as the previous gun, but yeah, and I guess I should have led that one a little bit there. Yeah, would have probably been a bit better. And here we go with that Tiger. Goodbye. So I told you I killed him. So now here I go and try to position myself so that way no one can really, like, I use my turret to my advantage, and the arson of my tank is a little bit angled, so that way hopefully I can bounce them. Now I believe my ammo rack's on the other side of the tank. I believe so, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not really 100% sure on that. And shoot, there we go, there's another kill. That's my third now we're up to, which is pretty good. Coming along pretty fine and dandy. I was about to shoot there, and they ended up taking him out, so that was nice. Saves me the trouble of wasting a bullet for nothing, really, in a sense, because if I would have shot, that would have been a waste of a bullet. Because he would have been dead by the time I shot, so I was just, like, itching to pull the trigger off. Yeah, so here we got a low. Get a nice little shot on him before, he dies anyways. I think he does shoot me, if I'm not mistaken. Not 100% sure. I know someone over there does. Oh, maybe it's the Persian that shoots me. Yeah, I remember. But I know somebody over there shoots me. Yeah, see? So I'm thinking it's him. I think he spotted me. There's an IS-3 on my right trying to take shots at me, but he kind of missed miserably over there, so that's fine. We'll visit him shortly. There we go. Another shot. Another kill. That's pretty awesome. That was kill number 5, so that was all my kills for this match. Now the rest of the time is just damage, damage, and damage, which is pretty nice. So kind of can't complain here. I feel like I was robbed on this IS-3 though, because, you know, you'll see. And actually than that, and then I was going to go ram him, but, yeah, somebody else had to be there to snipe the shot, and just like I did a few times to other people, but, so I think it's a J-Panther back here shooting at me, so he did get a shot off on me, and I think I did bounce another one, so that was a nice little running shot, and where I got to shoot his gun, so either he probably repaired that, I would assume anyways. Oh yeah, that was kind of a bad shot on my part. Kind of like, you know, yeah, bad move. So that's pretty awesome. Somebody took him out, and that saved my arse a little bit there from some extra damage. So that's always nice when people actually help out. Yeah. So here we go. We're off to find that last person, and he's hanging around in D89, somewhere around there. It's like T95, if I'm not mistaken. And, yeah. Why are they always the last ones in battle? Is it because they're so slow? Could be. Could be. You know, they do have a lot of armor and all that crap, and are pretty tough to take down. I will have to admit on that. But, they could have made it a little bit faster. So that way you can actually get to battle and maybe not be the last one always hanging around. That and the fuck. The F-O-C-H. It's fuck in French, by the way, for all those people that always say fosh. You don't pronounce the H. Just saying, because I'm French, I would know. Yeah. So anyways, off we go. We're going to go and kill this T-95. Now that everybody knows where the hell he is. And why is it when there's always just one tank left, somebody has to stay on the cap? Like, really, we're like 6 against 1, or 7 against 1. Yeah, I think we can take a T-95, you know, like, just putting it out there, right? Then there's people that hang around in useless areas in the map, and they'll just, like, sit back and snipe, and they're usually the first ones dead because they went to the wrong spot to try to snipe. It's pretty funny. I see it a lot. So here we go, I bounced a shot off that T-95, which kind of sucks because he did get me in the end, but I think I do shoot him one more time before we all just kill him. So I'm thinking he's coming down here and he's like, oh, I'm going to get this guy. Nope, no you're not. So the second shot that I did hit on the big bounce, so which is unfortunate, but I managed to pin him there so everybody can get the kill on him, so that's pretty good. Worked kind of a team with the greenies there, so it was pretty good. Ended up doing like 7,000 experience because it was my times 2, so that was pretty wicked. I got myself 3,900 damage, 5,100 assisted, and 2,200 blocked, so that's pretty good, man. I can't complain. So it was a great match. Very great match. So that's going to help with the stats a little bit anyways, right? Now that I got this tank upgraded, I feel like a little bit more secure with it out on the field. So I placed top of the board, which was very, very nice to see. And I hope you enjoyed the video, everybody. So please like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time. Peace.